सर गर्म हो जाता है, एट टाइम्स यू फील दैट योर हेड इज हीटिंग अप. सो व्हेन आई वाज इन यू नो आई रिमेम्बर आई हैव हैड आई एम कॉन्स्टेंटली इन टच विद अ लॉट ऑफ यूपीएससी एस्पिरेंट्स एज वेल. और वो ये बहुत टर्म यूज करते हैं कि सर पढ़ पढ़ के ना सर फील हो रहा है कि सर गर्म हो गया, ऐसे कुछ गर्म हीट हो गया ऊपर. तो दे ऑफन यू नो मेक फन ऑफ इट कि इतना पढ़ पढ़ के वी कैन फील द डिफरेंस इन आर हेड. Hi everyone, my name is Anuchindal. Welcome to my channel. Today I have Aparajita with me. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly.
Yes, sir.
She has cleared RBI Grade B 2021 examination, the results of which were declared very, very recently. First of all, congratulations, Aparajita, on clearing the examination.
Thank you, sir.
Before moving with the actual interview, I think it's very important that students have a brief idea about you. So, if you can just briefly tell about yourself, your education, RBI ka keeda kahan se laga, from where did you come to know about it, what attracted you towards this financial and banking field, and then we will start with the actual interview.
Yes, sir. So, I didn't know much about RBI other than that it's the central bank of our country and mainly currency functions and also basic, the general public perception, I too had it in my mind. So I graduated in from NIT Jamshedpur in 2018, and I went on to work with Capgemini. And when I started working, I got to know about this examination from one of my colleagues. So it was a brief description that there is one such examination, but I was not much into it. But one, 2 to 3 times I got to know about this examination from him and that this is a very good opportunity and all. Then I did my own research, and luckily or coincidentally, my work at Capgemini was also related to digital payments domain. And I was getting to work with a bank called Nordea. It's in Sweden. So there was a exposure that I was getting into digital payments domain, and when I started reading more about RBI Grade B, so I thought I was able to connect it, and I got the idea that I can do something in this field. And not to forget that the immense opportunities that this exam provides, so I decided to take it up also.
Okay, you had told me briefly, you know, about your history while you were working. You had taken up the studies, and then you decided that it's the right time to, you know, drop out, to leave your job, and you know, prepare full time for this examination. So, if you can briefly talk about that, because that's a very big choke point for a lot of aspirants. Ki yaar job kab chhodein? कैसे छोड़े हैं. सो दैट मेकिंग दैट डिसीजन ऑल यू नो ऑफन बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स.
यस सर. सर आई वुड से आई मीन ड्रॉपिंग आउट ऑफ अ जॉब और लीविंग अ जॉब इज अ बिग डिसीजन फॉर एवरीवन, बट इट आल्सो इट शुड आल्सो कम विद एन असेसमेंट. आई मीन व्हेन आई वाज प्रिपेयर आई अपीयर्ड फॉर 2019 एग्जाम एज वेल, एंड एट दैट मोमेंट आई कुडंट थिंक टू ड्रॉप आउट ऑफ माय जॉब. सो I was preparing at that time, and even if I couldn't clear phase one, I kept on with my preparation for phase two, because I had it in my mind that once I am confident with my preparations, once I have covered the syllabus and there is a mindset that yes, this time I can do it, then I will feel ready to leave the job, and there will, till that time I will have sufficient experience and I will not feel that pressure that later if something happens I couldn't do well in the exams, I can come back to my field. So that was, I would say, a calculated decision. But again, when you leave the job, there are moments of self-doubt, but again, you can, you know, self-talk can help that you have made the right decision.
Very well. I think you took a very mature decision at that time. You, as you said, calculated. I think it was very mature also at the same time, because you understood the importance of financial independence, the importance of working after a certain point in time. And I think all the other aspirants can take a you know, leaf out from this learning, that you know, we should always plan properly before actually getting into something as big as RBI or UPSC or any other competitive exam. Okay, let's get into the preparation now, phase one and phase two, because you started with your phase two prep before your phase one prep, as you said. So let's talk about phase two first. What were the sources? What were the strategy? How did you plan preparing for it? Because you don't have any background in these areas. Yes. So it must have been very, very alien. I can understand that. So yes. how did you go ahead with the preparation?
Yes, sir, definitely. I mean, it was very difficult for me to narrow down the sources, even understand what does the job demands and what does the exam per se demands. So what I did, first of all, I contacted some of the seniors through LinkedIn or Facebook and understood what all strategies that they, you know, applied. And I also went with some YouTube videos like Topper's Talks and their strategies. And I noted it down and I customized as per my strengths. Like, there is no one size fit all strategy for anyone. Someone is working, someone is not working. So I basically, if I go by phase one, so I understood from my experience of 2019 that the reasoning is going to be a tough area for me. I was comfortable with English because of the college placements also. I had a practice and I was into reading articles and blogs. So English was okay for me. And quant and reasoning, I understood that I need proper practice. So after 2019 attempt, I focused on taking up quizzes and understanding my weak points and then working on that.
So phase two ki tayari mein, of course, you identified the sources, you created probably the strategy on an Excel sheet. How did you move forward with your preparation? Like, pehle kya kiya? Did you pick up finance first, economics and social issues first, current affairs kahan se uthaya? All those things, if you can talk about in a little detail.
Yes, sir. So, sir, when I went out with the syllabus, I mean, when I went thoroughly through the syllabus, I realized that management is something which is very concise. And in my college, I had one subject, principles of management, and it was very, and there was a great overlap. So I made my own notes and so that I'm done with it and I will just have to revise at the time of examination. So one part was covered. For ESI, I would say Runal's videos. I mean, that was the starting point, because for someone like me or someone who is not from economics or finance background, those videos are really simple to understand. And even going through those videos, if you are reading newspapers or any other material, it becomes very easy to understand. So that was for ESI. And later on, I went on to add some points like whatever current affairs I am reading. I was reading current affairs from Viz and IAS monthly compilations also. So what they do that for current affairs, they're also adding some static parts. So I was ready with a framework of notes and I kept on adding some useful points or current affairs. So that was all for ESI. And for finance, it was really difficult because, it was very new for me. So for finance also, I went on with noting all the terms like bonds or securities that, I mean, now I can understand it, but at that time it was very difficult. So I started with watching videos, because when some term is very new to you and you just read the definition, it will not get into your mind. So I used to watch videos and then I went on Google, visiting Investopedia and making a, you know, crux of that, noting down concise definitions and all. So it was, I prepared my notes that wise. And it was all done when I was in my job. So I was ready with a set of my notes that I can update or revise simultaneously.
Amazing, amazing. Yes, I think a very straightforward, very concise and very nice strategy you had. Yes, what was your reaction to the descriptive, the change in the pattern to a descriptive paper partially? How did you take it?
Sir, if I talk about descriptive, I mean, I was happy also and a bit confused too, because descriptive, because I am into creative writing and writing some articles or something. So I was sure that I can do it well, but again, it adds a bit of subjectivity in the examination. So I was confused that because MCQ, you know, after doing with the exam, after you are done with the examination, you are very much aware that how was the examination.
Yes.
But this time I couldn't predict how my phase two will be. So there was a bit of confusion, but overall I find it good because,
because of the prior experience that you've had in writing, etc. Right. I think that's very important. So here is a small learning. It is not just about what you do at the time of your preparation. I think your previous knowledge, your previous interests, all those come into play and, prepare you better for such an examination. Yes.
In fact, I would like to mention one point. I mean, there was one paragraph in when we were dealing with the questions in English. So there was one paragraph for sand mining. And I used to follow one newsletter. It's Finshot. It doesn't take much of your time. Even if you're not reading newspapers and you are appearing for some, exams in finance or economic field, they provide very simple and concise summary of some issue. So when I went into the examination and the English paper, that paragraph was ditto what I read into the Finshot's newsletter. So it's all about being aware about, whatever is happening through any means that you like. If you're not regularly following newspapers, you can follow other sources, maybe YouTube videos, maybe other things that you find comfortable.
Yes, I think very well said. All those things are very important. In fact, I remember I used to listen to Finshots on Spotify regularly, and they used to recommend investing in certain securities once every week. And I would, that way I would find new opportunities, new companies, and I would, research on them. I just picked one, stock out of all their recommendations over 6-7 months, but it paid off well. But at the same time, I understood how to do the primary research.
Yes, sir.
Because that made it more interesting. That made it more exciting. Instead of, researching on blue chip companies, I was researching on these small cap stocks.
Yes.
So, usse knowledge kahin na kahin badh rahi hai, and probably 10 years down the line, that might come handy.
Yes.
Right. So that is how it works. You always have to be on the lookout in this new digital age where, there is so much information, so much availability.
But then again, you have to pick it up well because over information again, you have limited time. So
yeah. Sar garam ho jata hai. At times you feel that your head is heating up.
Yes.
So when I was in, I remember I'm constantly in touch with a lot of UPSC aspirants as well. अब वो ये बहुत टर्म यूज करते हैं कि सर पढ़ पढ़ के ना सर फील हो रहा है कि सर गर्म हो गया, ऐसे कुछ गर्म हीट हो गया ऊपर. तो दे ऑफन मेक फन ऑफ इट कि इतना पढ़ पढ़ के वी कैन फील द डिफरेंस इन आर हेड. ओके, लेट्स मूव टू फेज वन, बिकॉज ऑल्दो यू हैव हैड सम एक्सपीरियंसेस इन प्लेसमेंट्स, बट आई थिंक यू वर वेरी फ्रेश व्हेन इट कम्स टू क्वांट रीजनिंग एंड जनरल अवेयरनेस. नो यूपीएससी बैकग्राउंड एज सच. सो हाउ डिड यू go about them? How did you prepare for them?
Yes. So from last year of my college, I mean, I had UPSC in my mind, although I didn't appear for it. But yeah, I was trying to cover not regularly news. I was not reading newspapers regularly, but I was trying to follow the current affairs well. I mean, from whatever sources I used to come across with.
Mm-hmm.
So there was a background, but yeah. I tried to cover the current affairs for RBI grade B specifically, considering the previous year questions, what all type of questions are asked, and covered it thoroughly for last three to four months. And also when the time was left for me, I covered it up to 6 months. And it helped me because this time some of the questions were asked from last 6 months also. So, that's one thing. And also practicing through quizzes and MCQs, because for me, if I talk about myself, it may vary from person to person, but again, repeatedly revising the things may become monotonous. And when you practice it through MCQs and when you commit some mistakes, then you, consciously remember it. So this is something which helped me in remembering the facts.
Mm. I think very well. Yeah, you took a very organized approach towards it all. I think that is how it helped.
Yes.
Let's move to the interview, because you are a fresher with only 1 year of experience, probably 1 or 1.5 years approximately. What was the direction of the interview? Being an engineer, a lot of engineers are there who are often confused and don't know how to prepare for the interview. So, kaise prepare kiya and the direction of the final interview?
Yes, sir. So the most, you know, thing, like the question that we engineers were so fearful of. I mean, many of the people were also asked this question, that why so many engineers are coming? And I used to think many ways, how can I answer this question? But ultimately, I thought there cannot be a perfect answer to this, because there is no such thing, because many people are opting for it and there is no perfect answer for it, simply. So later I realized that instead of focusing on some such questions, I can work on my own profile. And that's what happened, because interviews, generally what I realized, it go with a flow, whatever questions are being asked, and the way you answer will lead the interview. Because no matter however technical things I read, I started my first or second answer with my experiences from life, so it went on with that thing. I mean, it became very conversation based and very experience based, rather on the key points or technical or factual information. So it also depends on that. And having a very clear understanding of why you want to join RBI or any other organization per se. So having a clear understanding also reflects there, because you should have a vision if you are going to join the organization. So that's, and I try to inculcate these things in each one of my answers. So I think this is what helped, and I was able to converse well. So covering the profile based questions well and HR questions well, I think it really helps, because the technical questions may always, you will always have one or two questions that you could not answer. And they won't mind if you say that, sorry, sir, I cannot know.
Right. I think you're bang on target there, because I have had some seminars with selected students who are now working in RBI and who help students pro bono very regularly through me. And they always say that it is about 70 to 80% about your profile, your HR, your personality, and about only 20-30% about, the technical part, especially if you're an engineer, not from the background. Yes. They understand that you probably will not have a detailed understanding, and they will train you for it. That's the reality. Right. Aparajita, it has been a beautiful experience talking with you, I must say. At such a young age, I think you've done wonderful for yourself, and you have shown the real girl power that exists in our nation. I was, in fact, interviewing another successful candidate, also another girl, and we had a long discussion about girl power and, the importance of independence for everyone in our country. So before leaving, any message that you would want to drop out, to all the future aspirants, that you would want to share with the aspirants, so that they can, take a leaf out of your experience and, it helps in their preparation?
Yes, sir. I mean, if I would like to give a suggestion, that's one thing, before moving on to prepare, you should have a clear strategy. You can, listen to every, different opinions, but then again, you have to customize it as per your strengths and weaknesses. Many a times we, focus on either overemphasize on the strength or on the weakness. But you have to, take both sides. And one thing that I faced while preparing for exams, that self-doubt comes. It's very natural. But then again, you have to do the self-talk and bring back to the focus, focusing on preparing for the examination and not letting that affect your preparation.
Amazing. I think that's very, very important, especially for all the freshers out there who have very little experience. So, thoda sa एंजाइटी होना नॉर्मल है, दैट हैपेंस बिकॉज यू आर सो सीरियस अबाउट अ करियर एट दिस स्टेज. वी डोंट वांट टू लूज आउट ऑन यू नो एनी अपॉर्चुनिटी. वेरी वेल सेड अपराजिता. ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर योर फ्यूचर. आई एम सर्टेन यू आर गोइंग टू हैव अ वंडरफुल टाइम इन आरबीआई. एंड थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर कमिंग ऑनलाइन, शेयरिंग योर एक्सपीरियंस विद ऑल द फ्यूचर एस्पिरेंट्स. आई एम वेरी श्योर दैट दे आर गोइंग टू यू नो टेक सम इम्पोर्टेंट messages out of your learning and be able to prepare better. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.